Let's look at the third method of finding rank of matrix, and this method is called as by reducing it to echelon form. The first point here is this is like the default method. So in exam, supposing if you get a question, find rank of matrix A, and if no method is mentioned, it is not said that solve using a particular method, only just have to find rank of matrix. The best method that you can use is the echelon form because it is the quickest of the fastest of the all. Of all the methods. Well, let's look at the points here. The first point says only row operations are allowed. Okay, so no column operations, only row operations. Sometimes this is called as row echelon form as well for that reason. Second is reduce matrix not to identity matrix but an upper triangular matrix. Understand what is the upper triangular matrix? Sometimes we write this as UT, that's upper triangular matrix, and this basically means that if this is your diagonal value and below these diagonal elements, every number has to become zero. See, everything below diagonal is zero, and that is my upper triangular matrix. So if this is your upper triangular matrix, you have to reduce matrix to an upper triangular matrix. And once you do that, now just see what the rank is. Rank is number of non-zero rows. Okay, so let's solve this question and you'll understand things better. Let's reduce the matrix A. Okay, no column operation, only row operations are allowed. Let's do the row operations then. The first operation that I'll perform here is R2 plus 2 times R1. I'll double this one and add it here. This will become this 0. And let's do R3 minus R1. Now let's perform these two operations and see what happens. Now A gets simplified to 1, 2, 3 minus 1. Then these all will become 0 for sure. Okay, let's perform the first operation. If I multiply R1 by 2, this becomes 4. And add it here, this is 3. Multiply by 2, this makes this 6, and minus 3 is going to be 3. Multiply by 2 is minus 2 and minus 1 is minus 3. Alright. And then let's do R3 minus R1. So this is 1 minus 1, 0. Then 0 minus 2 is minus 2. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. And 1 minus plus 1 will become 2. And then this is 1, 1 minus 1. Okay. My target here is to reduce that matrix A to an upper triangular matrix. So let's do that. See, what I can do is I can make these two zero, these two rows zero. See what I'll do? I will do R2, the second row, minus 3 times R4, the fourth row, and R3, the third row, plus 2 times of R1, and then they both will become zero. The R2 and R3, both the rows will become zero. Let's see what happens. A gets reduced to 1, 2, 3 minus 1 as it is. Now R2 and R3 both will become 0 and the last row will remain as it is, 0, 1, 1 and minus 1. So this is my simplified form of matrix A. And now one last step I have to perform to make it upper triangular matrix, I can just switch R2 and R4. So if I do that, R2 and R4, if I switch them, this A will become 1, 2, 3 minus 1. 0, 1, 1 minus 1, that's switched, that is swapped over here, R2 and R4, and now this is 0 anyways, and R2 comes here, so I get 0, 0, 0, 0. Now, if you look at this matrix that I've got, the reduced form of A, you will see this is the diagonal of a matrix, and because every value below the diagonal are all 0, so this is an upper triangular matrix. Now, as soon as you get upper triangular matrix, the rank of matrix is written as a number of non-zero rows. So if you see the first row, this is a non-zero row. And if you see the second row, that is also a non-zero row. So this is first and second. These two rows are non-zero rows. So from here, I'll get rank of A is equal to 2. Let me write that down again. That rank of this matrix A is 2 because number of non-zero rows is equal to 2. Okay. And this is the echelon form, the easiest of all, because you don't have to reduce matrix to an identity matrix or anything. Okay. You just have to apply only row operations, but remember that you're not supposed to apply column operations. Okay. Only row operations, reduce it to the upper triangular matrix, and the rank of A is finally number of non-zero rows. Non-zero row basically means that the row should have at least one value non-zero. Okay, last two rows are zero rows and first two rows are non-zero rows. And the rank is number of non-zero rows. And that way I decide the rank of matrix. This is my method 3. And also remember that echelon form is going to be your default method. So if, like here, there is no specific method is mentioned, in that case you always opt for echelon form, okay?